things that the enemy does is he puts a guilt trip that's not genuine contrition. He puts guilt trips on people and make them think they're either not good enough or they're too good for something or they don't understand or you're too dirty for God to use or God doesn't have anything significant for you or I wish I had that ministry or I'll never amount to anything. I'll never carry that power or he'll never forgive me for this. I mean, he gives you a whole long list of why you can't live a victorious life. And I'm here to tell you he's a liar and the father of it.
Yes, yes, that's good.
He's a liar. Satan is a liar and there's no truth in him.
Amen.
Jesus did not die for us to be weak.
Amen. Amen.
But the enemy will make you think that anyone who is strong, that's too much.
Come on.
And I will never be that way. And
that's
I'm
good.
Telling you, you are overcomers.
Yes.
This is not a pep talk. I'm going into sanctification. You have to understand how valuable you are to God. You matter to God to the point where if it was only you, he still would have come and died on the cross and took and suffered shame for just you. That's how much you mean to the Lord. And the enemy doesn't want you to feel that way because of everything that's going on in the world. And how can God care that much about me and there's billions of people on the earth? Because God is love. He doesn't have love. So no matter what state you're in, he loves you. No matter what you've done, he loves you. He just doesn't want you to stay there. And the reason why God has put this in my heart so heavy, because I lived defeated for years thinking a certain way, not realizing the power and the promises were real to me too. He cared about that little black girl from Akron, Ohio too. Not just a family name, not just a family heritage, not just a line of people who preached and teach and suffered and prayed. He cared about me. Out of billions of people. Enough to give me personal attention and to forgive me of my sins and continually cleanse me and continually work with me and continually chastise me and continually groom me and continually work and work and work. Until you see what you see today, and I still have a long way to go.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
I still have a long way to go. But I never knew the Lord could be this good. I never understood that God cared. God cared about me. Me. I know he cares about us.
Right. Come on.
But I'm here to tell you today, God cares about you in your situation. He cares about everything that you care about. I have had miraculous things happen to me since I moved to South Carolina. Some unexplainable things. I'm telling you, I never knew the Lord like this.
Yeah. That's good.
Prayer is powerful. And the enemy will make you think your words don't mean anything because they don't sound the way you would like for them to sound. You have no idea how you affect the spirit realm in your prayers to the Lord. They're effective. They're more effective there than they are here.
Yeah.
They make things happen there to fix your situation here. They make things happen there to fix you for what you need to go through here. Every prayer, not some, every prayer, and prayers don't die.
Hey, hallelujah.
So prayers that people pray for their grandchildren and their grandparents. They pray for their grandchildren and pray for their children and pray for their family members. God hears it and is remembered and is always coming before his throne as a sweet-smelling savor. He just takes his, does it in his time. But don't you ever think your prayers aren't effective. Don't you ever think God's not here? Don't you ever think he hears your cry? Don't you ever think that he's not paying attention to you? He's right there when you're doing wrong.
Come on.
He's right there. And he still loves you. And he still wants you.
Yeah.
And he still wants to fix you. And he still wants you to have the best. And he still wants you to overcome this world.
Yes.
And he still wants you to be like Jesus so you can be a joint heir with him. And so you can receive glory with Jesus. He still wants that for you.
Yes.
It's never too, you keep waking up, it's not too late.
Yes.
As long as there's breath, there's hope.
Hallelujah.
As long as there's breath, there's hope.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Now for the hard stuff.
Amen. Come on with it.
Get your paper and pencil out and all that little stuff you do. You know, I like to teach. And God gives me what he gives me. Another thing, the Lord's still talking, so I'm going to do this, but the Lord's still talking. Stop comparing yourself to other people. How you are is how God made you. What God gave you is what he gave you. Work what he gave you. Does everybody understand that? Work what he gave you. Because the world is missing out on you. He doesn't have to duplicate things. We like to mimic people who have power because we may want power, we're insecure and everything. Stop all that. We saw their power. Why would you want to look like that? We already saw it. And then you are uniquely made in Jesus and will never experience you because you're trying to be like somebody else. So God wants you to don't compare yourself to people. Even your spiritual growth in the Lord, don't compare yourself to people. Don't compare your spiritual growth with someone else. Don't do that. Ask God, teach me how to be with you. Ask God to say, Lord, teach me how to be with you, how to walk with you, and he'll do it. Sanctification, I haven't given you the scripture yet, but we're going to go there. Sanctification is the process of becoming more like Christ by purifying your hearts and minds through repentance, fasting, prayer, and spiritual practices or spiritual renewal practices. And all throughout the Bible, sanctification is a calling to align yourself with the will of God. To align yourself with the will of God. Sanctification is a process and an outcome. It's not just a process, but it's the process and the outcome. And it's achieved through consistency in working through the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Now, the Holy Ghost is a guide which empowers you to process being sanctified. Because you can't do it yourself.
Amen.
You can't do it yourself. I'm doing, I'll leave it that way. You can't do it yourself, but it helps to guide you through the process of being sanctified so that you can arrive at an expected outcome. What God has for you is not determined by how you feel or what you know. or what you imagine, what you understand. So this is why I started out by saying this may be a little hard for some, because some of you are new here and you may have never heard of this, and then you've heard of churches that are cultic, like where you are restricted and you are can't do certain things, and they have a lot of control over you, and you have to deny yourself. And
come on.
You can't have your own mind.
Amen.
You can't look like the warp. I'm gonna let it just drop. Because I asked the Lord, I said, Lord, let your word just bring understanding. Because we're going to get there. Sanctification is an ongoing, for you who are taking notes, number one, restricted, consecrated, dedicated, sacrificial, decreased, submissive, humbling, subservient way of life.
Yes.
In order to be more like Jesus. Okay.